around, and we either need to shut the doors or quiet the crowd.
Now the air stays in here.
Yeah.
Tom, look at that.
I brought that for different reasons. Okay. If I can get this thing going again.
Here we go.
I got it.
Would you like to say?
Nope. Next item on the agenda is item number 7, discussion of an amendment to the bond and 1/4 cent county sales and tax resolution. Let me start. My name's listed there. I just want to start with a little bit. I'm sorry, Henry. Little bit of update on the resolution, on the thoughts of the commissioners in relation to the two issues on the bond, on the ballot, excuse me, the bond referendum and the sales tax. And let me first start by outlining the change and why the change is there. We did have our, it's approximately quarterly city county association meeting, it might be once every 4 months, but we do meet with all the elected officials in the county who are invited to this. My understanding is we also listed as a public meeting or make it a public invitation, do
yes.
we not?
Yes.
So that posting was there, Mr. Boney, to address that concern. And our intent was to provide education to all the municipalities over what we're trying to do and structure, because it is confusing. And it gets more confusing because there's more misinformation out there, and people kind of develop their own stories with this and run it. So what we have and what's out there in the community is not necessarily at all related to what the real matters are. You are correct that Commissioner Massey and Commissioner Boswell and myself attended the meeting and were there to help explain why there are two issues on the ballot and what we were allowed to say by law, and talking to bond counsel, talking to our county attorney, to come up with a basically proposal that, number one, deals with the issuance of bonds to construct the facility, that is the creation of debt, and then the payment of that debt by the introduction of a 1/4 cent sales tax increase. We could not on the ballot say on the bond proposal, and Clyde, you stop me if I make a mistake here, but we could not on the ballot say that the that the issuance of the bonds would be paid by a sales tax, and we could not on the ballot say that the sales tax was going to be used for debt service on the ACC building and economic development. We could not do that. So we were trying to explain, and did introduce that concept to the municipal officials that were there last week ago, Thursday night. In conjunction with that, we did a presentation that included Craig Honeycutt, our county manager, Mac Williams, president of the chamber, and myself, to go through the process and the history of why we had to structure the issues on the ballot as we did. Not that we were particularly happy about the confusion that it was going to discuss, but that's what we were required to do. In connection with that presentation, we did ask for input from the municipal leaders that were reading the information we had distributed. And we heard specifically that night from, on very specific points, from City Manager Harold Owen, from City Manager Graham, Chris Rollins, from Mebane's Town Manager Robert Wilson, all who said, we need to be specific on the use of the proceeds from the sales tax increase. Now, a little bit of math. When this was initially, and again, anybody stop me, but when we initially provided our estimates on the dollars to come in, it was estimated that in 1 year, we would get approximately $3.8 million Of the $3.8 million, $1.3 million would be dedicated to the debt service for the ACC facility over a 20-year period. That left $2.5 million. When the original resolution was passed by this board, there was a ceiling or a cap of $5 million in that resolution. And the reason that was in there in the beginning was to basically give the commissioners flexibility that if after 2 years nothing was happening with respect to economic development and the infrastructure and land improvements that that Commissioner Sutton mentioned earlier, then we would at least have the ability to discuss other sources, other uses for that particular stream of money. And without exception, that evening, the town city manager said, no, don't do that. You're leaving it open-ending. It will be even more confusing. Commit the funds to debt service. Commit the funds to economic development. That's the message that Craig Honeycutt heard. When my understanding, and Tim, I'm not speaking for you, but correct me if I'm wrong, but my understanding was when you reread the original resolution that was passed, you were concerned about the $5 million limit and in fact had a separate conversation with Craig Honeycutt. Right. At no time, either during, after, or since that meeting, have I had any personal discussion with Commissioner Boswell or Commissioner Massey at all. Now, I don't know if the two of them have talked, but I can assure you that I have not had any discussions with anybody other than the feedback that was shared with our county manager. So based on the feedback that he received in conjunction with our county attorney's further study, we have decided to bring back to this full board a amended resolution that basically states for the quarter cent sales tax, should it pass and should the issuance of the bond pass for the construction of the ACC Applied Technology Center, then in fact proceeds of the sales tax would go $1.3 million to the debt service and $2.5 million for economic development efforts primarily centered on infrastructure, land acquisition, and improvements. And that's where we are. I think the questions that you have raised in your letter, I think they need to be addressed. I think that it was appropriate that we turn those over to our county manager and certainly respond to your concerns. I do not think that the actions taken to date in terms of educating the municipalities and frankly educating the general public on what we're trying to do has been inappropriate. I'm still concerned that the media is not totally clear on the way this thing has to be structured. It is difficult, and as we have tried to explain it, it still has not come out exactly right. That education process must continue. I think our thrust in educating the folks, the officials in that meeting, as well as the general public, has to center on the fact that number one, there are two separate ballot issues and why. Number two, to address the needs of the ACC Applied Technology Center. And number three, to recognize that to do the things that many of you mentioned this evening as it relates to increasing the property tax base, to providing jobs without necessarily accompanying them with cash incentives, needs to be done by getting economic development efforts directed particularly at projects that will increase the property tax base. That is the intent and the sole intent of the portion of the sales tax revenue that would be dedicated to economic development. Now, I want to stop there for a minute and see if our attorney, our manager, other commissioners have anything else to say. The amendment that is before us tonight is an action item. Simply removes the $5 million cap from the resolution and directs that the $2.8 million coming in on an annual basis would be directed toward economic development activities and improvements.
I'd like to say, you know, you alluded to me and what conversation I had with Craig.
What happened, I read an article in the Times News where it mentioned the $5 million. And I thought, man, that's not right. And I called Chris and felt pretty bad about it. Chris read it to me that, yeah, yes, that's what it said. And I felt bad that I had let that get by me. So I called Craig and I told him that I was opposed to the $5 million cap because I felt like, number one, that's just a drop in the bucket to what you got to spend, in my opinion. We're going to roll the dice and roll it right. You know, you get in, you play it piecemeal and so forth and so on. You're not going to get anything, I don't think, with the direction there. So I told him I was opposed to the $5 million cap, and on a secondary basis, I was opposed to the fact that maybe we would limit it at five, get nothing, basically, to show for it, and then channel that money into other things that's not being told. I was opposed to that possibility. So, I'm in favor of the economic development side of it. That I've said all along, I'm in favor of infrastructure, parks, buildings, everything that we can do to sophisticate our effort. And I mean sophisticate. Giving cash to me is not sophistication. That's secondary or on down the ladder. I want us to roll the dice big if we can get this approval. And $5 million wouldn't do it. And that's why I was opposed to the cap.
And I don't disagree with either one of those points. I think that's right on target.
And then when I told Craig that, he said, well, we can amend that. Possible. And I thought, well, but we've got to vote on it. And I was thinking maybe the votes wouldn't be there.
No, I'm good with that.
So, and that's all I know about it. So I didn't talk to Linda, Tom, Eddie.
No, we have not talked about it.
Didn't talk to Bill Lashley. And
we didn't even talk to each other at that meeting.
No, we didn't. And if anything, and Tim, I may have heard you say something about it on the radio. That's the only other, I don't know if you talked about it on Talk Home another day.
You mean I called the radio show?
Oh, you called somebody, you called in somewhere. Tim, I agree with you 100% on that. And when we introduced that and that resolution, I think we, in my mind, we're saying, okay, let's start out here, and not knowing how it would all look when it was all said and done. And I do agree that it's going to take some money to make things happen and to go out and be able to get sites ready, which is what companies I feel like are really looking for in this market, is to be able to come in and say, you know, they're ready for us. We can put our building or, I mean, you know, there's other alternatives there too. So,
well, and the reason, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
The reason I asked Mac just to hang around, just in case there was any questions about, you know, how that would work with the committee that would be formed to review that on case-by-case basis with your committee, then you would still bring each one to this board and it'd be up or down.
As far as I know, the commissioners keep the money and you all control the money. There's no entity that's created, no board it goes to for somebody else to manage. It's a recommendation. That will bring recommendations to you, and decisions made by the commissioners to spend them up. You guys keep control of it.
Right.
Well,
and that is.
And all of this discussion, I think, and Ms. Boney specifically, I think it's important that we need to educate the citizens, the voters, about how this works. And the example of the Applied Technology Center, there's misinformation out there about that. And that's an important piece of this total package. But the fact is, and Tim alluded to it, four things can happen. And if one of those things is that the ACC package doesn't pass, but the sales tax does, I think it's this board's desire to still use that money for economic development purposes. And Henry, you said it tonight, you said it last time, you said we don't need to go into more debt. Well, we're earmarking that debt with the sales tax money. So it's the only way that the college can build their new facility, because we don't happen to have, and they don't happen to have, $15 million on hand that we can just write a check for. But it's not the incurrence of debt without a specific repayment source that's earmarked for that. So if that's out there, that's not correct. And as Eddie just said, it's not with property taxes. As a matter of fact, if the ACC bond issue passes and the sales tax fails, then this board is not inclined to authorize the issuance of the bonds. And that's, I don't think our position has changed on that. Yeah. So when we, and we do have to, it's confusing to everybody, we do have to educate on any and all levels on exactly what the options are and how this is going to work and what the needs are. And Mac made one statistic that I think everybody needs to know, said one thing, and Mac, not putting you on the spot, but the comment about where we are in relation to those 20 counties, what's our investment? Do you mind just taking a second and summarizing what you said that night? I did not know that.
Your county manager, about a year and a half ago,
did a survey of the 20 counties in North Carolina, I think with a population of above 100,000, about how much public money was budgeted for economic development. And at that time, I think we were ranked 19th of the 20, and we're heading toward 20.
I heard a lot of people tonight who were against the concept of incentives, including I think some of the sentiment that Tim feels, may not realize that without that kind of investment, we're really at a loss for even making the cut by not having the land and infrastructure ready. And those are facts. That's not a sales job. That's just where we are. And the facts are, okay, we went from 10% to 9.9% unemployment by the end of July. Now, the labor force here has not significantly increased since the year 2000. And those are facts. Now, we've got a bunch of people who are underemployed. You know, I looked in the paper today. Chris had an article on the top 10 employers of Alamance County. Was that your article, Chris?
It was not.
All right. Well, it was your paper. It was a good article. Two of those top 10 employers now were temporary staffing services. What does that say? Our employers are afraid to commit. They're afraid to commit, so they're going to get temporary folks where there's no health coverage.
And no benefits.
Exactly. And having them on a per hour so that if something doesn't turn around, something doesn't change. Two out of the 10 employers we have are temporary personnel agencies. I think that's scary. I think that is scary. So, yeah, I think we've got to create the environment where businesses will want to locate in Alamance County, and we've got to have the site ready or close to ready when they're ready to move. So, sorry, didn't get on soapbox. Other discussion?
Well, I would like to address the letter from Mr. Bowman. Clyde, can you address that letter that he just said?
About our illegal meeting.
Yeah, about our illegal, all our illegal stuff, that we violated the open meeting law, which.
I'll be glad to give you a more detailed response after I read it. I've just looked at it. I haven't studied it.
Well, and as I committed and we opened this discussion, you will do that and get back to us and get back to Mr. Boney with a response.
We'll do.
Is there a motion to?
The one thing I would like to respond to, however, is your description that the actions at that meeting were educational in nature. Mr. Chairman, I want to say this very respectfully, but I want to say it very firmly. If this board and the county manager continues on the perspective that advocating for either or both of these bond referendums is educational, we're on a collision course. This statement that is in the proposed resolution that you all brought to that meeting says, we, the undersigned municipalities, also hereby encourage our citizens to vote and support the bond referendum and the sales tax increase. That is not educational, Mr. Chairman. That is advocacy. And advocacy is what is absolutely prohibited. And so what I want to be clear on is if this board continues to claim this is educational, we're on a collision course. It's going to end up with some conflict between us and this board. It is not simply informational. Now, with respect to the meeting, I don't have a position particularly with respect to the wisdom or not of which of the old resolution with the $5 million or the new resolution without it. I don't have a particular personal opinion.
Okay, but that is what the agenda item is right now.
It
so
is.
I'm going to caution you. I've already committed to you that our county attorney will review your concerns and get back to you. Do not take this time to further your agenda in your newspaper for your front page at the expense of the workings of this board.
I'm not sure what that means, Mr. Chairman.
It means I'm asking you to sit down.
Mr. Chairman, the one thing...
No, I'm asking you to sit down.
You have been so warned, Mr. Chairman.
It sounds like we've been so threatened. Is there a motion to accept... No, we need a motion on this.
I'll make a motion that we revise what we did in our earlier meeting to remove the cap on the economic development side of this and continue with what we proposed to do for the ACC bond.
And economic development.
And economic development.
Is there a second?
Yes. Second.
Any other discussion? No, sir. You are out of order, and I'm going to ask you to help me if necessary. Is there any other discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Thank you. County manager reports.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And one thing I do want to mention, if I could as well, with respect to that resolution that was submitted, it was stamped completely, draft on it. That resolution has been revised and sent back to the municipalities. That our attorney looked at and reviewed, and it truly says this is educational purposes only. We have basically stepped away from that process and basically have left it up to them and said, do with it what you may, we're done. So we have sent that back. We have changed some of the wording, and I will agree that some of the wording probably was should have been changed. However, the new resolution that Mr. Boney does have a draft of does state that for educational purposes that we do want to educate the public. So I will say that. A couple of things I do want to mention to you. We had a little bit of discussion tonight about the landfill for Mr. Childers, and we had that at our last meeting. I just wanted to give you an update from Greg Thomas about the Randolph County Regional Landfill. They will be opening in mid-2014. So we have a couple of years before we should see any changes to the flow. But again, they are looking at a for-profit company coming in and managing that landfill like Waste Industries or Waste Management. And if it's a for-profit company coming in, it may affect our flow at a later date. But again, it's not expected to open until mid-2014, but we'll keep you updated on anything that we do here.
Would that be an option for Carborough?
That would be an option for Carborough.
Are they going to run out, or are they shut out before that time?
July 1, 2013 is when they'll be shut out. Or when Orange County would no longer accept MSW, which is municipal solid waste.
When the Orange is sending theirs to Durham, I think, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, I don't know if the cost is prohibitive for, I think Carborough will have options, but I think they were looking at transportation and easier options other than the transfer station. I don't even think they've got a transfer station sited yet in Orange County. So, but any more information we'll get, we'll be sure to let you know. Any questions? And then on just a reminder, September 12th is a follow-up to the Economic Summit meeting from 8 to 11 a.m. at the Kernodle Center in Burlington.
Would you, every time I talk to you or Ronnie or Mac, I get three different times. It's either 8 or 8:30, but not both. Would you clarify that and let us know?
I think breakfast is at 8 and the meeting starts at 8:30, but I will
clarify.
Is
your understanding too?
We'll clarify that.
Clarify and send the email.
We'll do that. And that's all I do have.
Commissioner comments?
I don't have any.
No, commented out tonight.
I'll go to Sheets and get $300.
Let's go. Good idea.
All right. If there are no more comments, do we have any announcements?
Thanks.
If not, stand adjourned. Thank you.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur at 7 p.m. on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioner's website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the County Commissioners on the second and fourth Wednesday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 10 o'clock p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for